everyone. Thank you for watching. Today's video is going to be a new declutter. I'm actually going to be working on three different sections in my makeup collection. So I have my makeup like sprays over here. I also have my makeup primers, and then I also have my like setting powders slash pressed powders. So I want to work on each of these three different collections. They're smaller in my makeup collection, but definitely I don't need as many as I have accumulated for each of these different categories. So I will have my playlist, my declutter playlist linked down below in case you want to catch more of my declutters, but why don't we go ahead and get started. Alrighty, so primers were the closest one to me, so we're just gonna go ahead and start with primers. Alrighty, so I do see these four here from CoverGirl. These are the new ones that they sent in the package with their foundation. I tested that one out last week, and I used in there the, which one did I use? I used the Skin Smoothing Primer. I did like it. I'm gonna go ahead and keep that. I'm gonna keep the pore minimizing and the illuminizing so I can test these out to give my thoughts on them. But I typically do not need a color neutralizing primer. I don't deal with a ton of redness, so I can go ahead and put that into like a giveaway pile because I'm not even gonna open this one. So I'm gonna go ahead and put that one in my pass pile. For my declutters, if I have something that's not opened or not used, I can put it in a giveaway. If I bought it myself and didn't use it for some reason, I can put it on my Poshmark to sell. Or if it's like very lightly used and I bought it, again, I can put it on my Poshmark. But other than that, if something was sent to me and I've used it, I can pass it on to friends and family as well. So that's kind of just a little thing with my declutters. I have this one here. This is from Makeup Forever. This is their Step 1 Skin Equalizer Primer. It's a mini guy, and I remember there was a point in time where everybody was so obsessed with these primers. I actually went through one of these minis, and I have another one. Well, this one. I know that I've used it quite a bit, and I know there's not a ton left in here, but also I have not reached for this one in a very, very long time. So I'm going to go ahead and put that one in the pass pile. I also have this one here from MAC. It's their Prep and Prime Skin Base Visage. I don't know if I'm saying that correctly, but it's basically their primer, and I actually have never used this. I got it like fairly recently-ish, but I still do want to try it out, so I'm going to put that in my keep pile. I have this one here from Julep. It's the Blanket Canvas and Mattifying Primer. I actually really do like this primer, even though I don't always need a mattifying primer because I am more dry. Sometimes once we get into the warmer months like we are now, I can find myself being not as dry, so sometimes mattifying can help. So I'm going to go ahead and keep this one too. I really do like that primer. I have a couple here from Flower Beauty. So we have the Pore Minimizing Primer, also the Hydrating Primer, and the Illuminating Primer. I'm going to go ahead and keep these two. These are two of my favorite primers. Honestly, I'm about out of the Hydrating Primer because I use it so much, but these two I really like, and sometimes I even use them together because I get hydrating, but at the same time I get pore minimizing, which I think is nice. The Illuminating one, I do not think I've even used this one yet. So again, I could put this one into, I have a future giveaway coming up here soon, so I could even put that one into my giveaway box because I don't believe that one has ever even been opened. But I like illuminating primers, but more often I'm reaching for hydrating versus illuminating. This one here is from Pure Cosmetics. It's their No Filter Blurring Primer. This one I have also had for a very long time, and I just didn't love it. It comes in like this dropper form here, but it reminds me, and I know I've heard other people say this too, that it reminds them of the Becca backlight filter, and I actually don't like that primer. I've decluttered it out of my collection, and so I also don't like this one. It's just a little bit too, like, there's not glitter in it or anything, but it almost just kind of, it makes me feel like my skin is like sparkly after I use this, so I really don't like this one. And it doesn't help, you know, it doesn't help with my pores, and it doesn't help make me look hydrated. It just like makes me look shiny. So I'm gonna go ahead and put that in my pass pile. This one here, this is one of my favorite primers. I talk about this one fairly frequently, I think, I like to think, but it's from Amazing Cosmetics. It's their Anti-Aging Face Primer, and I just really like this one. I think this one is more of like a silicone-based primer, which normally isn't my absolute favorite, but something about this primer, I just feel like it really kind of like smooths out my skin really well, and I just like the way my skin feels when I use this one, so I'm gonna go ahead and keep that one. This one here is from Tarte, and this is like their, does it have the name on this one? Yeah, it's the Clean Slate Timeless Smoothing Primer. This is actually my second one of this. I believe this is like their mini, like their smaller size. I think they have a bigger one as well. And I went through one and I absolutely enjoyed it. So I got another mini somehow, like a point perk or something like that. Or I think it was even on the Tarte website. You could get like a, with your points, you can redeem them. And so I picked up this guy again, and this is how much I've touched out of it. So I used to love this. Like I said, I've went through a whole one, but I just can't even remember the last time I even reached for this one. It is very good at smoothing, but I think it's something like, I don't like dipping my fingers in this one or something along those lines, but I just haven't reached for it a lot. So I'm gonna go ahead and put that in the pass pile. I have this one here from Milani. This is their Prime Shield, their mattifying and pore minimizing primer. I've had this for a while. I put this in one of my videos recently. The YouTube didn't make me buy it video, and I talked about I just kind of like bought this on a whim one day and I didn't even realize I was buying mattifying and I was more dry. I've had it for quite a few years though, and it's about almost gone as well, so I don't really reach for this one too much anymore either, so I'm gonna go ahead and put that one in the pass pile. I have this one here from Lorac. This is the Light Source 3-in-1 Illuminating Primer. It's a smaller guy. I think this came with like a palette or something like that, I want to say, and I don't think I've ever used it. So again, I could go ahead and put it into my giveaway pile because I've never used that one, and again, I don't really need like an illuminating primer. Okay, so this one here is one of my favorites. This is from Smashbox. It's the Photo Finish Primerizer, and yeah, this is just one of my favorites. I've used this one quite a bit. This is the mini size as well, and I love it, so definitely keeping that one. This one here is from Urban Decay. This is their Urban Defense Complexion Primer. It's supposed to be a smoothing primer, and it does have SPF 30 in it. I'm gonna go ahead and keep this one. I can't say it's my absolute favorite, but especially because it has the SPF in it and we're reaching, you know, we're getting into summer, I'm starting to pay more attention as to what it is I'm putting on my face, especially days I'm gonna be outside a lot. So I'm gonna go ahead and keep this one. Let's see here. This one is from Becca. This is the Velvet Blurring Primer Perfecting Base. I don't really like this one. I felt like it was, like when you apply it, it like pills up pretty easily on the skin, and sometimes it's hard to lay makeup down after it because it just like, I don't know, it does funny things on my skin. So I'm gonna go ahead and put that one in the pass pile. This is another one of my favorite primers that I talk about. This is from Number 7, the Airbrush Away Primer. I really like a lot of Number 7's products, makeup and skincare, and this one is just very, it's kind of like a moisturizing primer in one, and I just like the way it makes my skin feel and look, so I'm gonna go ahead and keep that one. This is one of my favorite primers. This is from Becca. It's the First Light Priming Filter. This, I probably only have like one or two uses out of it, but I'm gonna get those one or two uses out of this primer before I put it into my little empties bin. But yeah, this is a great primer. I really enjoy this one, so I'm gonna get my last drop out of that one. This one here is from Kevin Aucoin. This is the Sensual Skin Primer. And it's kind of an interesting primer because you kind of like click this up. This one I actually really enjoy in the summer because it's very lightweight, and again, it's kind of more of like a moisturizing primer at the same time, but it makes your skin really soft. Honestly, if I was doing this declutter in the winter, I might declutter it because I would know I wouldn't reach for it a lot, but just the other day I pulled this one back out again to use it on my skin, so I know as we're entering warmer months, I gravitate towards it during the summer months, so I am going to go ahead and keep this one. It's also a pricey little guy, that's for sure. And then this last one here is from Milk Makeup. This is their original blur stick. I did have the Luminous blur stick and I immediately passed that on. I think I sent it down to my niece because it just didn't really work out for me. But I do like the regular blur stick. And I do have larger pores, especially around my cheek area. So I like to use this the days that I need help just kind of filling those in. So I'm going to go ahead and keep that one. So that's it for my primers. So let's see how I did. For my primers, I decided to keep 14 and I am getting rid of 8. I'm not too mad though because, you know, a couple of these CoverGirl ones I still need to try. The MAC one, you know, I still need to try, and then I just have some of my favorite primers in there too. So I think that's pretty good. So keeping 14 primers and passing on / decluttering 8. Next up, I want to work on my loose powders / pressed powders. Now, if you've been watching my channel for a while, you've heard me say things like, oh, I don't always set my face with powder. Oh, I don't prefer loose powders. And I feel like that's definitely changing. Again, a lot of times in the warmer months. Sometimes I don't like to even wear like, you know, full heavy foundation if I'm going to be outside for a long time or in the sun. And a lot of times I will just wear a powder. So again, that could be what it is. But even some of my loose powders to like set under my eyes, I've just been reaching for them a lot more lately. But still, I don't need this many. And I see someone here that I know I can get rid of. So let's just go ahead and jump into it. So this one here is from Pixie Beauty. Yes, of course, Aries is here. This one here is from Pixie Beauty. And this is their Quick Fix Powder and Translucent. Now, this one I really did quite enjoy when I first got it. And I feel like I got some good uses out of it. It does have a puff here that you can dip into the powder. But actually what I do is I just take this off and I would like dip my sponge into it. You can see that I do have quite a bit of product left, but I feel like even though I really did like it when I first got it, I feel like there's others in my collection that I know that I like more and that I reach for more over this one. So I'm gonna go ahead and put this one in my past pile. This one here I just got. If you watched my collective haul that I posted recently, I just made my first Beautylish order and I purchased this airbrush powder from Charlotte Tilbury, if I can open it. So this is the Charlotte Tilbury powder in medium. It hasn't even been touched yet. Haven't even done anything with it. So obviously this is going in my keep pile. This one here is from Pure. It's their 4-in-1 pressed mineral makeup, and I have mine in the shade tan. This is one of my favorite powder foundations. I've been buying this for, I think, over 10 years now. I've gone through several of these, and I just quite enjoy it. So I'm going to go ahead and keep that one. This one is from Laura Mercier. This is the Secret Brightening Powder. I bought this when everyone was raving over the translucent powder, but I was, especially like last year, 2 years ago, I was really obsessed with like super bright under eyes. So that's why I purchased this one. And I still do quite enjoy it and I do get a lot of use out of it. So I'm gonna go ahead and keep that one as well. This next one here is from Maybelline. This is the Fit Me Matte and Poreless Powder in 310. You can see that clearly I really do enjoy this one. This is something you like never see, is me hitting pan on products. So this is pretty exciting. But especially in the summer, I know I do get a lot of use out of this one. So I'm going to keep this one. I feel like I'm not doing as well as I thought I was going to. This one here is from RCMA. This is the original No Color Powder. And I got this sent to me from a friend. She sent it to me so I could try it to review, and I have chatted about it in a past video, and again, I really do enjoy this one. I think it is so fine on the under eyes. I reach for this one quite a bit as well, so I'm gonna go ahead and keep that one. This next one here is from Julep, and this is their Insta Filter Invisible Finishing Powder. Okay, so this one is another one that I really, really enjoyed when I first got it. I know it looks kind of strange because it's white, but it does go on like completely clear. And it does a really good job of like smoothing out the skin, and really it does, like, I feel like it does what it says, like it kind of puts a filter on your face. But I've noticed that I don't reach for this one as much. I'm definitely reaching for other powders more when it comes to setting my face, so for that reason I'm gonna put it in the past pile. This one here is from CoverGirl. This is one of my new ones, and I absolutely enjoy this powder so much. This is the Vitalist Healthy Powder. I have mine in the shade Buff Beige. Yeah, this is one of my favorites at the moment. I reach for this a lot, so I'm going to put that in my keep pile. This is another new one to me. This one is from Becca. This is their new Hydra Mist Set and Refresh Powder. I used it in one of my recent first impression videos, and I'm still, you know, testing it out, and I just got it, but I really do quite like it, so I definitely want to keep that. Put that in my keep pile. Okay, so this next one here, this is from Flower Beauty, and this is their translucent powder in MM1, I think it is, or their Miracle Matte Powder Translucent Finishing Powder. Okay, that's what it is. I don't even want to open this because it is so messy. Like, I do not like the packaging on this at all. It's just way too messy. It gets everywhere. It's just a bit of a disaster, and I don't love the powder, so I'm gonna put that one in my declutter pile. The next one here, this is from Maybelline. This is the Super Stay Better Skin Skin Transforming Powder. I have mine in 30 Warm Nude. I really enjoy this powder as well. I'm quite surprised I haven't hit pan on it. I keep this one in like my going out clutch for like touch-ups when I'm out and about. I actually do like the sponge that comes with it. But yeah, this is another good one. I'm going to keep that one. This one here is the Laura Mercier Translucent Powder. I had a friend send this one to me so I could try as well. So this is the original translucent that everybody loves. I do quite like it. I like it for my under eyes and I like it for my face as well. So I'm going to keep that one. It is fairly new to me as well. And then this last one here is from MAC. This is the collaboration with Patrick Star, so it's Patrick's Powder. I know a lot of people really enjoyed this one, but I did not. When I reviewed it, I said I felt like it made my skin look a lot older, and it just, especially with having dry skin, it just wasn't very flattering. So I'm gonna go ahead and put that one in my pass pile. For my powders and pressed powders, loose powders, this is my keep pile, so I'm keeping 9. And then this one over here is my pass pile, and I am going to be passing on 4. So another category down. Let's get to the last one. The last pile here is my setting sprays, and this recently has gotten out of hand. I keep them in a drawer and I can't fit them all anymore, so I definitely need to do something about this category. So this first one here is from No. 7. This is their Hydrating Mineral Water Spray. I mean, you can see that I've made a pretty good dent on this guy. I actually don't really like it for the face. It truly feels just like water, and I want my sprays to have some benefits. But what I like using this for is getting my brushes damp. When I notice there's a spray that I don't love for my face, I will keep it around to use for that, because then that way I can use the sprays that I do enjoy for my face and not kind of like waste it on brushes, if you will. So that's what I've been using this one for, and I will use it all the way up. So I'm gonna go ahead and keep that one. This next one here is from Flower Beauty. This is the Seal the Deal Long Lasting Finishing Spray, their matte finish. I really enjoy both of Flower Beauty's sprays that I have. I like the matte finish just as well, even for, you know, especially for the summer. I don't mind having a mattifying spray, so I'm gonna go ahead and keep that one. This next one here is from Revlon. It's the Photo Ready Prep Set and Refresh Mist. I was talking about this one recently when I was reviewing new drugstore products, and I said that I really enjoyed this one. I'm quite impressed with it. I reached for it quite a bit. I feel like it really helps keep my makeup last longer, which you can't say about every spray. And so this one does impress me, so I'm gonna keep that one. This one here is from Pixie Beauty. It's the Makeup Fixing Mist. I'm actually gonna pass this one on. This is not my favorite spray from Pixie. I don't like the sprayer on it. It's a little bit too intense for me, but I also just don't really feel like it's doing a whole lot for me. So I'm gonna go ahead and pass that one on. This one is one of my favorites though from Pixie. This is their Hydrating Milky Mist. You can see that I've used quite a bit of it and I really do enjoy it. I really like the way it makes the skin feel. I like using it as a prep for makeup too. I feel like I really like this one, so I'm gonna go ahead and keep that one. This is from Skindinavia. This is the Makeup Primer Spray. This is my OG spray, one of my first ever sprays that I got, and I still really enjoy this one. This is a really nice spray for if you're not gonna do a lot of foundation, because it's kind of like the moment you spray this on your face, you look better. I don't know how it works, but it's so good, so I am gonna keep that one. This next one here is from Smashbox. This is the Photo Finish Primer Water. You can see I've made a pretty good dent into this one as well. I do like this one and I do like to use it before my makeup as a primer spray, so I'm gonna hold on to that one. This next one here is from Pixie Beauty, and then again, this one is the Vitamin Makeup Mist. I feel like I've done a pretty good job with this one, but again, it's just not my favorite from Pixie and I just don't feel like it's doing a lot for me, so I'm gonna put that one in my pass pile. This next one here is from CoverGirl. This is the Look Lock Up All Day Setting Mist. I did review this one and I said I didn't like it. I don't like the sprayer on it. It's too intense for me, just like that Pixie one. And I also didn't really notice a lot of benefits with it, so I'm gonna put that in my pass pile. This next one here is from Pure Cosmetics, and this is their hydrating spray. Again, I put a pretty decent sized dent into it, but again, it just doesn't do much for me. It has a very, very fine spray. Like when you spray it, you're like, did I spray that onto my face? Which I do like because it's not disturbing the makeup at all, but again, I just have other ones I enjoy more. So I'm gonna put that in the pass pile. I have this one here from MAC. This is the Fix Plus. I have another one that you'll see too, but this is the original Fix Plus. I love this. I just went through one, and this is just one of my favorites. That's all I can say. This always has to be in my collection. Next one here is from e.l.f. This is their Post-Workout Cool Down Mist. I really wanted to like this one. I truly did, but I just don't. I've used it as a primer spray, I've used it as an after spray, I've used it as the workout spray, like when I get done working out and I come into my office, I spray it. I don't like the way it feels on my face. Like it feels like it never really settles in, like sinks into the skin. And I was like, well, no big deal, I'll use it for my brushes to get my brushes damp. I do not like the way makeup goes on when I use this to damp my brushes. Like it's so weird. I don't know what it is about this spray, but I do not like that one. So I'm gonna put that in my pass pile. This next one here is from Mario Badescu. This is the facial spray with aloe, herbs, and rose water. I think this might be my second one that I've used. There was a point in time on YouTube where everybody raved about this one. And you can see I've made a pretty good dent on it. This is one that I like to use again in the summer, especially if I've been out in the sun. I think it's just because it says it has aloe in it. I'm like, I'm totally helping my skin. But I do like this one, especially in warmer months. So I'm going to go ahead and hang on to it. Again, so this one here is the MAC Fix Plus in Lavender. I was just talking about this one in a video and I was saying how much I love, love, love the scent of this. Definitely want to keep this one. I mean, Fix Plus, I'll just always have in my collection for sure. This next one is another one from Skindinavia. This is the makeup finishing spray. It has bridal on it, and honestly, like, whenever I'm in weddings, I always take this one. I spray my face, the bridal spray her face, the other bridesmaids will spray their face, and I really do feel like it's helping lock the makeup into place, so I quite like this one. I'm gonna go ahead and hang on to it. The next one I have here is from Urban Decay. This is the Chill Makeup Setting Spray for cooling and hydrating. So again, going into summer months, I use this a lot. I can tell I only have probably half left because it is one of my favorite sprays. I used it yesterday. We were out and about all day at the farmer's market, and this is the spray that I chose. So I do want to keep that one. And this next one here is from Pixie. This is the Glow Mist. This is one that I bought because like everybody was hyping it up, and it really does make your skin glow. But for me, it's almost like too much. And like when I use a setting spray, I really like to like spray my face a lot. And you cannot do that with this one because you are going to just like, it's just like too much. So while I think it's good, I think it does what it says it does. I don't need it, if that makes sense. So I'm gonna put that one in the pass pile. And then the last one that I have here is from Flower Beauty. So this is another of the Seal the Deal. This is the hydrating setting spray with the dewy finish. I really do enjoy this one as well. I like a lot of products from Flower Beauty, but this one really impresses me. I love the spray on it. I love that it smells really good. So I'm gonna go ahead and keep that one. So that's it for primers. So let me put them together and see how I did. For primers, I decided to keep 12 and then I'm getting rid of 6. I didn't do quite as well as I thought maybe I would, but again, looking at these, I'm like, yep, nope, I don't really want to get rid of any of them. So final count for the primers, keeping 12, getting rid of 6. And then after that, that's going to do it for today's declutter, decluttering 3 different categories in my collection. I hope you enjoyed seeing this declutter video. Again, I'll have my playlist linked down below if you want to see other declutters that I have done. But other than that, if you guys did enjoy this one, I hope you'll give it a thumbs up. I hope that you also consider subscribing before you go, and I'll catch you guys in tomorrow's video.